So thank you so much, sir. To move forward, now I would like to invite our another speaker, who is Mr. Arjun De Silva. He is the senior lecturer at University of Kelenia. And Arjun, he holds a management degree from the University of Sri Jayawardenepuram. And at university, he wears many caps in his day-to-day work, where he teaches management at the university and also an integral member of the Research Council of University of Kelenia. And today he will share the research journey of University of Kelenia. So Arjun, now over to you, and you can share your screen.
Right, thank you very much, Shalini. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Now, this is about University of Kelenia's journey in the last couple of years, last 25 years, how University of Kelenia progressed from scrap to excellent. The purpose of the presentation is to explain the importance of research in Sri Lanka. We are starting from the national level. Then to explain how University of Kelenia used Cyber and Scopus to improve world-class research publications. To compare and contrast the number of publications and the level of impact of publications in Sri Lankan universities. And finally, lessons learned and suggestions. The outline of the presentation: where are we as a nation? Sri Lanka versus world-class universities, research publications, and Sri Lanka publication snapshot, top contributors to national research institutions, research ranking of each university, 1996 to 2019, Sri Lankan state universities, world-class publications, research growth, Sri Lanka versus UOK, University of Kelenia, University of Kelenia progress since 1996, the major challenges University of Kelenia faced when you implement the policies and protocols, the solutions, and the University of Kelenia model to improve research, where we focused on people, policy and protocol, perks and platforms, overall research performance of the university, and view count, field-based citation, publications by subject area, quick links, topics, clusters, collaboration, academic corporate collaboration, top collaborating institute, and finally, lessons learned and suggestions. Now, before jumping to the University of Kelenia case study, let's look at the Sri Lankan research data as a whole. Now, there are more than 240 countries in the world. Out of the 240 countries, Sri Lanka is in the top 10, the least 10 list, who is spending the least amount of money on research and development. You can see here, Israel is spending 4.27, Korea Republic 4+, Japan, Singapore, all these countries are spending a lot of money on research and development, whereas Sri Lanka spends only, it's less than 1%, it's less than even 0.1%, which is a terrible problem in Sri Lanka. We'll have to address that issue as well as a nation. And Sri Lanka versus world-class universities, now as a country, we have published less than 15,000 world-class research during last 10 years. And as a university, Harvard University does more than 15,000 publication two times. It's like 30,000 publication per annum. And it's a very pathetic situation in Sri Lanka. As a nation, we are not doing research, proper research, quality research. And overall research performance in the country, so far since 2008 to 2019, 14,335 publications, and the impact of this publication, which is measured by the citation count, is 200,000. Again, a huge problem. And we do have only 15,000 scopus and top quality researchers. Now, when you look at this subject area publication, you can see the real picture of how research is happening in Sri Lanka. Now, here, this area is related to medical sciences and related sciences, one health and medical sciences here. One third of the research is coming from the medical. That's why we do have a very sound, very good and very reputed health system that is based on the research, very good research. And computer science, that is also one of the prominent industries emerged in Sri Lanka during the last couple of decades. Computer science research is also very good, and engineering research. Now, these three areas, medicine, engineering, and computer science, those are the three areas you can see research is good in the country. All the other areas, including the business management, social sciences, humanities, are yet to grow. Coming to the university system, Sri Lanka does have the state universities and non-state universities accepted by the UGC, and some are not accepted yet operating. You look at the state university system, the top contributors to the national research are the state universities. You can see the last year, 2019, 100% of the research happened in Sri Lanka. Out of 100%, 94% is coming from Sri Lankan state university. Only 6% of the research done by the other institutes like Cognate Research Institute, CBSL, Central Bank of Sri Lanka, very less number, very pathetic. When it comes to other countries, like, it's a big number, 20%, 40%, some countries like states, they do have private firms to do research, good research and publish. But in Sri Lanka, 94% of the research is coming from state sector universities. And out of this 94%, you can see this ash color line, trend line. These are top six universities: University of Peradeniya, Colombo, Ruhuna University, Moroto University, Kalani, and Jayadhanapura. This 86% of the research published on index journals are coming from these six universities. Now, we'll have to think about the other universities. They are considered to be teaching universities, yet there's a high potential for us to, like, for the top six universities to progress to the next level, the research universities. Now you just look at the last in or last decade's numbers. Peradeniya published 4,500 top class publications. University of Colombo again close to 4,500. Moratua 2,600. Ruhuna 1,600, Kalani 1,600, and Sri Jayadhanapura 1,200. So all the other universities are less than 1,000. Jaffna is progressing there. Now, when you look at the very recent years, from 2010 to 2018, University of Moratuwa has the highest growth. Now, in a few years, 5-10 years, they will become the top research university in Sri Lanka if the trend is going to continue like this. And this is the snapshot of University of Moratuwa, Colombo, Peradeniya research growth. And we are here, University of Kalaniya. We have been in the fifth position, and slowly we are progressing to the number fourth position. And let's take a look at how we did our work in order to develop this. Now, when I read through the data, analyzed this data, I identified that there's a direct relationship between the national spending on the research and development and the national trend of the research publications to the university levels. Now, when you now see, you can see the peaks of this. When the national research is climbing up, the institutional research also will climb up. And on the other hand, when national level of research comes down, university research is also coming down. That's a direct relationship now. That what does this mean? That means you'll have to do more and more university research to keep the number of national research up. So there is one thing. And here, this is the progress of the university since 1996. We started below 40 in 1996, slowly declined. Thereafter, in 2000, it started like progressing, especially the medical faculty. After 2000, it started climbing up slowly. And the science faculty. And here we have a, decline in trend because of the, there can be several reasons. One thing is like we went after quantity and also we had a national level research problem during this period of time, so that there is a small problem here since 2014, because they have like those days the University of Kalani had somehow tried to uplift their research. As a result, in 2015 and onwards, the there's a huge progress in world-class level publications. Now, this is what we faced and this is how we overcome. Now, we had 15 major problems identified by the Research Council of University of Kalani with the help of all the deans and the vice-chancellor those days. Now, these are the 15 problems. Number of publications, the quantity per annum was very low. Less number of citation counts among academics. Low number of high index corpus publications. Many native language publications, lack of English titles, keywords, abstracts and full papers. Academics present research at low grade conferences. This is also one problem, like people use the academic freedom or the university funds to go and present in the very low grade forums, conferences, and university journals and conferences are not having index status. That also one of the problems. Availability of data on publications, benchmarking issues we had. Awareness of index journals, that also we had a huge problem because the academics didn't know the best sources to go and publish, best journals to publish, and they didn't know how to find it. Technology awareness problems, difficulty to pay and publish, low motivation to do research, difficulty to find contemporary research areas, less index publications, and finally less collaboration. Now, the Research Council since 2014, used some of the platforms, and we signed an agreement with the Cyber and Scopus, the Elsevier, in 2016 to get the insights of the happenings in research. So here we address these 15 challenges using the data provided by the Cyber, Google Scholar, Clarivate Analytics, Google Scholar, again, Research Council Information Systems, Scopus, Simago, ABDC, and CABS, Chartered ABS here, and finally, Intelligent Journal Finder, and again, Research Council Information System. Now, each problem we didn't have data, exact data, so that we use these platforms in order to find out the data and take the corrective action later on. So the corrective actions and the research management process we develop using a UOK research development or research improvement model, and like this, a UOK model to improve research. We focus on the people and policy and protocol, perks and platforms. Here this is the detailed version of the strategy. Now, when it comes to a university, we have three types of We identify three types of people: university staff, the students and collaborators from outside, and administrative people don't do research, good research, like publishable research. But academics were motivated, and they were advised, and they were in fact forced to do research. And students, we had 3-4 levels: the undergraduate students and the diploma level students, and postgraduate students and the PhD students. And we included the Cyval analytics in PhD students and especially DBA students curriculum, so that they could find out the contemporary research areas very easily, and they started using that. That was a part of their curriculum, and they had training sessions on that, and we gave them KLN email addresses so that they could easily access to the platforms. And finally, collaborators from outside. Early days, we had collaborators, but it was purely based on the personal contacts. But we made it little official. The university made it little official, and we officially helped them to find out the collaborators from elsewhere. And the policy and protocol, we had three things in the policy and protocol: the benchmarking policy, and we formulating strategy, and implementing phase. Here we benchmark three local universities: University of Peradeniya, University of Colombo, and University of Moratuwa. These three were performing really well, and they were developing their research culture within universities really well, so that we benchmark. I don't like to use the word copying, because the cultures are different, but yet we identify the best practices happening there, and we try to do that. It worked. And also we looked at the Harvard, Cambridge, Yonsei, and Oxford universities, how they do research, but their setup and the administrative hierarchy structure is different, so that we could not go and just directly do the same thing that they are doing there. But we somehow benchmark some of the good practices, and we try implemented very successfully. Then the formulating strategy part always had been done by the research council with the dean's committee meeting. Those days I can remember the deans were Professor Science Faculty. It was Professor Nilanthi De Silva from medical faculty, and Professor Bimali from science faculty, Professor Jayamaha from FGS, and Professor Dr. Narada from management faculty. These four professors went to one of the training sessions in China, organized by LCVI. I'm not sure whether it's Times Higher Education or LCV. I think it's Times Higher Education. Then they are the ones who actually brought this concept. We'll have to move to higher ranking methodology, and we'll have to change the university structure to a different university, to the next level. We'll have to take the university to the next research university level. So that Professor Sunil Chandra, who was the chairman of Research Council, hosted this series of Dean's Committee meetings, and they are the ones who actually suggested some of the Research Council and strategies, which was monitored and governed by the Research Council later on, with the support of the three levels of administrative structure in university: the Vice-Chancellor level, Dean's level, and the Head's level. And the implementing phase was chaired by the Research Council Chairman and the Vice Chancellor, and we had progress meetings, all kinds of things, and we looked at the analytic reports every week, and we found out some of the areas to improve, And we had every month research council meeting. There we discussed about the concurrent problems, and finally we came to, you know, a working model of this proposed mechanism. And perks, there were like government financial support, which is the academic research allowance, and the university financial supports, various publication fee reimbursement, and prizes were given for Scopus publications, like so many financial support given by the university. Finally, the platforms. So here we had three platforms: data platform, technological platform, and the performance platform. Here, data platform, Cyber, Scopus, and Research Council Information System. These three were the main sources of data and information we use to generate reports. And technological platform, we had reference managers. Now, early days it was OneNote. Then, since it was a proprietary version, we thought of like moving to Mendeley, which is again another Elsevier product, which is free. So that we had a series of workshops to teach the Mendeley to the academic and the postgraduate students. Then we had a special research toolkit for the academics, and we had several sessions on that also. And finally, intelligent journal finder. This was pretty much useful for the academics. So this kind of a tool that the academics finish off their paper, then they can copy the abstract to the intelligent journal finder and get the most suitable journals back to do publish. So this also worked really well. And finally, performance platform. We set KPIs, we had ethics, because whenever you have policies, practices, and protocols, there are always problems. So that we had a very strong ethical platform to for the academics not to take the upper hand of the problems of the policies. Then progress reviews, and finally corrective actions. Now that's the proposed research improvement model, and we somehow got it done, and it was really successful. And the next thing was the mindset of the people, to change the mindset of the people. Now the final outcome is to make the university a research university, but people are reluctant to face change. They don't like change. So that we had to set the mindset, we have to prepare the mindset first, so that we used a down not a top-down approach. Actually, it's the other way around. Like we just wanted them to transform their administrative departments to research departments, then research faculties, and research university. Final result is research university. Now here, this talks about the platforms and policy and perks. We obtained the Scopus and Cyber subscription, and all the faculties and institutions affiliated have been given access to Scopus and Cyber. And here we promoted Scopus publications, 50% increase of cash prizes if it is a Scopus publication, and increase foreign travel grant amounting 200,000 to 300,000 if it is a Scopus related conference. We change the structure of the human resource structure of the research council. We appointed research managers and intelligence team to do the data work for each faculty and the department, and work really well. And policy, protocol, people, and perks. And we gave research support during sabbatical leave, and also obtaining assistance from emeritus professors. Now this was just a suggestion, it never worked. an innovative pilot research project funding scheme that also one of the schemes really worked for us. Then we promoted the innovations, and we had press conferences to give the due recognition to those who have found new things, and it also worked. So many financial schemes support given to the researchers. And overall research performance as a result of this, since 2019, it has grown to nearly 100%. Now here, 2014, we had less than 100. 2015, it's close to 100. It's 100 plus. And 2019, we had Scopus publication, 219 Scopus publications. It's a 100% development during last 4-5 years. Then the view count also improved from 1,500 to 3,000 plus. Field weight citation impact, here 1 to 1.8 like. And publications by the subject area, now here is the problem. Now, when you look at the medical faculty research and the science faculty research, here it dominates. Like more than 50% of the research, more than like 70% of the research is coming from medical faculty and the science faculty. All the other faculties are still not to that level of research, public good research. Some do have inherent problem, like Faculty of Humanities, some departments publish in native languages, which is not accepted by the English bias Scopus and Cyber or Science Direct. Now that is a problem that we'll have to address. I'll be talking about this in the final slide. And here to motivate the authors, we frequently publish the top authors, and we awarded the top authors, and the links were shared so that they could test check their names on the top author list, and they somehow tried to reach at the point. So that is one of the things, and this is one of the appealing things that we found in Cyber, the topics and topic cluster platform. Here again, the University of Kalania, this area, actually this should be like this. This is the Harvard. This should be filled with dots. This is the diagram we must have. I know. But this is the the illustration we have, so that we somehow, as the Research Council, tried to fill it, these lacking areas. Now, since we don't have pharmaceuticals department research much here, we promoted the medical researchers to do collaborative research with pharmaceutical industries. Right? So that is one thing we'll have to work on. This model is not yet implemented, so it's under that's in progress. So here we'll have to improve, fill in the blanks here. Then only you can go to the to the research university level. You have more good publications. We don't have engineering at all, and business economics very poor here. Mathematics again, chemistry poor. These areas you'll have to improve. And here collaboration, international collaborations. Less national collaborations, again less compared to other universities. Institution collaborations somewhat okay, because the industry average is like 26%, and single authorship is 5%. Single authorship, which is not accepted nowadays. It should be a collaborative paper. Then academic corporate collaboration, we do have very less number of academic corporate collaboration. So we'll have to improve that, improve a lot. And University of Kalaniya's top collaborating institutions, Colombo, Peradeniya, Oxford, Jayadanapura, London, in US, Ministry of Health, these 10. All these are medical and science. 90% of the research is from medical faculty, collaborative. And the final thing, the lessons learned and suggestions. Now, throughout my career, I found that we have to have a data center in the country, national data center. All the other countries do have national data center, which is a big data center, a real-time data center, which is connected to the provincial authorities and governed and administrated by the university. Because the 9 provinces, you have 9 top universities. They can govern the data center operations. They are, should be connected to one place. Now, this is one of the initiatives if you all can think about. Then we'll have to improve the 0.08% of research and development expenditure, both public and private sector, to at least 2% to bring the research to a decent level. And finally, now I talked about the native publications of some of the faculties. We'll have to have a proper Sri Lanka Journal Index, which is done based on the Scopus Index. And Thailand has one like that. So you maintain the Scopus quality in the Sri Lankan Journal Index. One day we can ask the Scopus, okay, our index is very much similar to your one, and it was done based on your parameters, criteria. Why don't you accept our journal and all the journals to your Scopus index one shot? So some of the countries are trying to do this. So I think the National Research Council, Professor Hemant, please consider this.
Yeah, I can well heard that is something that I also thought of.
Yeah, great. So if you can do this, it's one of the biggest thing that you can do to the academic community of the country, especially the native language publishers, the other publishers as well. So we can have a dialogue on this. So National Data Center, 2% of GDP on research and development, and finally Sri Lankan Journal Index. So that's it. Any questions, Shalini?
Yeah.
Do you have any questions?
First of all, thank you so much, Arjun. I mean, to me, this seems quite a journey, like how University of Kalaniya taken step by step to become a research-focused university where they are today. So, I mean, they were just few slides, but that requires a lot of work to reach where you are today. And not even on a university level, but to collect all this information and to share with the audiences takes a lot of time. So,
well, you have the platform.
Yeah, definitely. That's the reason we are discussing data and data analytics, because these analytics, they really help you to take a quick action. Like you have everything in place. Now you just need to take an action to do whatever you have in your mind. So I am asking the...
How many have you encouraged your members to be in the OSIC grid and Pardon? Have an OSIC registration?
Pardon? I can't hear you, sir, properly.
Have you encouraged your members to become OSIC members? There's a site called OSIC.
We encourage, it was a mandatory thing. If you are requesting a grant, it's a OAK ID. Yeah. If they're asking, you should have to have the ResearchGate account, you have to have the OAK ID or OSIC. ID and you have to have the Google Scholar account and you have to use the kln.ac.lk email for the correspondence. So these four criteria are mandatory. Otherwise, that particular publication won't be counted. Yes,
because
we did.
It's a good way of recognizing a researcher.
Yeah, yeah.
Using number. So I also must tell my own faculty, everyone should have a Google Scholar account and then QRS code given by the OC, right? I think this is the OC code you are given. So yeah. That the basic requirements, basic identification. Thank you very much, and it is very descriptive and it shows the real insight of the research of in the university.